I need to breathe.
I have been racking my brain trying to figure out how you telling Katagan the truth about the flame helps us. It doesn't.
You still believe that he has a plan?
I have.
Really?
I have an experience. Something that changed me to my core. The shepherd led me to her.
I'm sorry, but I don't believe into that.
And
if I have to believe, you know, they really sold that to us really bad.
Storm passed. War is coming. The last war
we'll
ever fight.
You turn into crystal. Wiped out. Like Medusa turned people into stone. It's the end of everything.
Like she didn't recognize him.
If I told you the AI that destroyed the Earth, destroying our minds in the City of Light, would that be any more believable?
We've seen our share of crazy, but that doesn't change the fact that fighting some war to become the Light is as ridiculous as the clothes you're wearing.
Is this the way for the writers to sell us that final story?
Clark,
not working.
Yesterday, we were offering it up in exchange for safe passage.
Yesterday, I was bluffing. Today, I'm standing in front of my best friend who I thought was dead. And I don't even recognize it.
I am the same person who brought you back from the dead, who refused to give up on you.
So much.
I know you don't believe in transcendence, but I'm telling you it's real. And I am asking you to believe in me.
Tears! Help us in tears!
Even if everything you're saying is true, I will not help that man start his war.
Tell me where the flame is.
Or what?
And now I am trying to save you! All of you! Clark, if you don't tell me where it is...
How we insisted on the you!
Let me help.
That's Melanie Blake.
Calm yourself.
That was rough, but that's Melanie Blake and that's Clark.
This one to end cap.
What?
You're not gonna do that to Clark. You shut up.
They all hate me. You don't know what we know.
Bellamy, please come back. Maybe not during this episode, but please come back.
See that patch over there? Patch and I welded that in place.
You're gonna offer her a deal? You're ready to trust her?
More questionable moments that I nevertheless respect locked me. She didn't think he was gonna finish the job once he knew, but he did to save you. That's what he said. When this is all over, we'll drink to him in the tower, okay?
I don't trust. Not sure that it worked. No, 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 no!
Apologies, my child.
You're there?
The Neuralink won't be able to
fight. No! You're seeing her suffering? And you're doing nothing, Bellamy?
I think she knows. She knows. Or she wouldn't be fighting. I'm sorry, Bellamy, you did what you could. Send the first of her friends to penance.
I'll take you to it. But only once all my friends are safe.
That's a trap. I love you, Clark. And I know that this is a trap. She's feeling betrayed and so sad. She thought that he was dead and now in there, but not really. I'm sorry, I can't focus on a character that I don't care of when that scene happened. You took it? You know what? Why not? It's better if.
Parents. I was alone for 58 days, but Clark helped me through it. Friends can be good at that too.
Nice. She has her own Monty and Jasper.
How about we go back upstairs, finish what we started?
No, 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 no. Stay there, stay safe.
You'll be on the wrong side of the door. You'll be on the right side.
Don't, please, Murphy, don't. That scene that they had before, none of you has to die. Oh no, I hate you, writers, I mean. I swear, oh, if
God, you're
Matthew...
back. You're not worried.
Indra, please save the day and save Murphy.
Open that door and you and your freak drained and girlfriend live.
Ah,
you're
dead.
If anything happens to John,
I blow the reactor. If you try to come in,
I blow the reactor.
They're bluffing here.
Are they?
Ah.
Getting out of the reactor.
Stay here, wait them out. When the door opens,
at least he's still alive. What now? You're gonna go to penance?
Why are they still restrained?
No one is getting violent. It's a good thing. They're being released.
Helmet on to protect your memory.
You good with this?
Helmet on. It's an inventor's first, is that it?
Maybe because they need Raven? You know, she's an engineer and all for the film.
He didn't send them to Sanctum.
Thank you for demonstrating why I didn't send you with them.
You know about this?
He doesn't know where they are. Only I do. I don't trust you. I do, however, trust the love you have for your friends. And once I have the key in the last war, the kids will all be free.
Shut up about the last war! I already had enough of it. That story really...
will save you anyway, for all mankind.
Can you save us from your bullshit? What now? Clark? Raven?
What the hell happened here?
Oh!
Gee, where to begin?
Clark with Raven and Disciples, maybe... Bellamy and the Shepherd are now on Sanctum. Two things. They managed to kill Shededa and to just have what they want. Or, like always, they're gonna make that planet explode. Really, that's the two options. I don't see any other options for Sanctum. At this point, you know, not a lot of people are still alive on that planet. It wouldn't take a lot of time to save the last ones who are still alive and to explode that planet. And what do we need really on Sanctum? I'm not sure. I never believed, you know, into that house that they were gonna live on, you know, with everyone. Into his or her room. I don't know why, but I believe more on Penance, you know, as the final planet on which they can all live forever and happy, because it's really like a virgin planet and they can build everything beginning with nothing. Everyone is gonna be new on that planet, so no one is gonna be superior to anyone, no one is gonna have the major role or anything, and no one is gonna have the castle or not. For me, Penance is really the planet on which they can live at the end and be happy on it. I'm really seeing that like that. But that's gonna be for the end. For now, I think that they sent Orgaz, you know, Octavia, Ico, and all of them on Penance, maybe. And you know what? In a sort of way, I'm glad that we have only Raven, Murphy, Emory, Clark and Bellamy still to worry about, still into the action, into the story. I'm sorry, but I love that. They are the main characters of this show. Octavia should be into this place with them, because Octavia is also one of the main characters, but you know, they are the delinquents. Not Emory, but Emory still is one of the main characters, and she's with Murphy, like they are just one character, you know, the two of them together. I'm glad if we are finishing the show with these characters, because they are the ones still there, you know, involved into the story, but also because they are the fucking main characters of this show, so they deserve that. I'm really glad. That could be great, you know, for the show, I mean, and for this final season, to really be focused on the main characters for this final episode. I'm not sure that it's gonna happen like that, but it could be great, really. Okay, about what happened during this episode, I loved the scene with Jordan and Hope, because I never made, you know, that link between these two characters, but Jordan was right, they lived the same stuff, in fact. So I'm glad for both of them that they have someone else like them. Even if for me they both have friends now and they have to understand it, but you know they are still teenagers on the show, so they need time maybe to understand it, that they are really a part of this group and they are really their friends. But that was great because I was afraid, I was so afraid after Diosa dying, you know, at the end of the episode 10. It was really like at the end of the episode, and we knew that the next episode was going to be only about Bellamy, so I was really afraid about the fact that after that we were not going to talk about Gilda, we were not going to take the time to mourn her, to honor her, like they didn't do for Bellamy, even if they thought that he was dead. I was really afraid of that, so I'm so glad that they took that scene, which was a long scene, to mourn Diosa, to honor Diosa, for Hope to understand what Diosa did for her, you know, like Jordan said, to save her soul. That was so great. I really loved that moment. And of course we had all of the discussions that new Bellamy, Void Bellamy, I think that some of you are calling him like that, had with these characters. I thought that it was interesting, you know, to have Raven and Ico together, because it's friend and girlfriend together, and Clark and Octavia together because they are the family. That was well done. And after that, what he said to everyone, that was really bad, you know, that was really sad to see him talking like that to Ico. Even if I don't like their relationship, that was really rough to see that, because we know what she represents for him. She was his girlfriend, so you know, to see him talking like that to her and saying to her that saving them, their relationship, you know, she said that to save us, she insisted on the us because she was talking about their relationship, like it means nothing to you. And he said no, he was gonna fight for the Shepherd no matter what, that the Shepherd was above their relationship and for the character, you know, for what it means. It was really sad, and it was sad also for Ico, because yes, during all of this season she fought for him. See, even if I don't like her character, I can be sad for her, you know, the two things are compatible. But I'm sorry to say that he didn't have tears when he talked with Ico. He was really saying that to her without emotions, and that was so rough. But when he was talking with Octavia and Clark, who are really more his family, he was crying during that moment because he was really trying to convince them, to justify himself, and that was difficult for him, and he saw that it was difficult also for them to understand him. Clark not recognizing him, Clark being so disappointed, and after that he was there when they tortured her, he said nothing, and she cried, because you know, for me she cried because she was disappointed, because she was sad, because she was losing her best friend, you know. For them, it's her best friend. For me, it's her soulmate, but why not best friend? You know, I'm playing your game, Jason. Why not best friend? I'm glad about what we saw about Bellamy during this episode. I'm sorry to say it, but I'm glad because we saw emotions. Like, he's not fully a disciple yet. He's not fully without emotions yet. He's not giving up on them. He's doing all of that to save them. He's saying it so many times, that's Bellamy Blake. Bellamy Blake trying everything to save his friends, that's fucking Bellamy Blake. Okay, he's lost. Okay, He has this face now that I don't understand, that I don't believe in, but at least, you know, he's there. He has emotions and he's fighting for his friends. That's enough for me to have hope for him to switch again. Again, like I said during my intro, he made an act of faith during the last episode to prove that he was a disciple. For me, he's gonna make an act of love to prove that he's still the heart of this show, the heart of this team. I cannot wait to see which one. For me, it's gonna happen like that. It has to. I'm not giving up on Bellamy, and what I saw during this episode is not encouraging me in giving up on him. Really, not at all. It's the contrary. I was expecting him to be so, you know, closed, to be without emotions, to be without anything, and no, we didn't have that at all. I'm sorry, but I'm glad. Maybe you're gonna tell me in the comments that I'm crazy and that he's really lost and that he can't come back. I'm not so sure. During the next episode, we're gonna have Clark on that planet, on Sanctum. Why not, really? If it can be the end of that storyline of Shedda, of the flame and all, please. You know that I don't love this show anymore. I loved it so much. I was obsessed with it during what? The four first seasons. But now I'm watching it because I still love the characters and I want to know what is happening to them. But the show in itself, the stories... I mean, that moment when Bellamy resumed all of what happened during the last seasons, yes, that was crazy what we watched during this show, that was fucking crazy. But no, it doesn't mean that because I believed all of that, you know, I followed you on that, I'm gonna follow you on that new phase, on that last war. No, really. It's not in one season that you're gonna sell me a lot of planets, a cult, a war, an enemy, a cult leader, disciples, losing emotions. I mean, they can believe into it. I'm following you on that, you know. But us, the viewers, believing into it because they're all gonna be convinced or brainwashed at some point. No, don't even try. I'm not gonna follow you on that. And again, I'm not even searching for an explanation for what Bellamy lived during the last episode because I don't really care about that story, you know. I really don't believe and don't care. I just care about my characters, you know, and what is gonna happen to them and them resolving their issues, evolving, and their future. And the stories about the flame, about this cult, about this last war, I'm following them, and sometimes it's okay, not great, but okay, but sometimes you are going so far with that, too far. It's so crazy, and sometimes it's so illogical also. Like, I'm still waiting to know why Octavia had this tattoo, this big tattoo. I'm still waiting for a lot of things to be explained, to be used. This episode was good. Not great like the last episode was. Even if I didn't like what happened during it, I can see that it was well done, well written, well played, well filmed and all of that. This one, I saw things which were not logical. I had moments where I was not really interested by what was happening on screen. So it was good but not great. But it was not bad because it was interesting, because we were progressing into the story, because we had some evolutions for some characters, because we had main characters and minor characters, the two of these things, not only one, the two of these things together. So Yes, it was not bad like some other episodes during this season were, really. No, it was good. It was enough. For me, you know, for this final season, after all of these disappointments that I had during some moments of this season, this episode was good. Tell me, what did you think about it? If you appreciated it or not, if you saw something that I didn't see or not. What do you think about Bellamy also, if he can come back or not? Tell me that in the comments. Okay, so it's all for today, for the 100, for you and for me. So it's all for me for now. So bye for now. Bye.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me that you built a time machine? Right.